Hi everyone, in this video, we'll be talking about NgOptimized Image Directive in Angular. The main goal of this directive is to improve image loading performance by enforcing best practices. So let's get started now. I want to quickly walk you through the default image tag before we actually go and implement NgOptimized Image Directive so that when we implement it, we know the benefits that it is offering to us. I have set up a simple Angular application here, which has 5 images right here, and on the browser, it looks like this. If you notice on the network tab, we can see by default, all the images are being requested by the browser, and we can see right here. So imagine if there are 50 images on your web page. In that scenario also, your browser will be requesting all those images eagerly, right? And one of the main drawbacks of this approach is that if you are on low power device or low bandwidth device, then it will be very much expensive for them in terms of page loading speed. So in order to mitigate this situation, we have this property called loading lazy. So with this approach, what your browser actually does is it only tries to make the request to the images which are above the fold content or which are on-screen content. And as we scroll the pages, it will gradually start to load other images as well, like so. And I think this is a very good optimization for low-power devices because the time that we are spending to download all these non-critical resources now can be diverted towards more critical resources. And also, let me show you one more thing quickly. Let me refresh the page. So here are 2 images, and if we look on the priority, the first one is high and the second is low here. But there is one more attribute called face priority, which will help to determine the priority for this image as well. So in this case, I'm going to add that property quickly as well. So it's called face priority, and then we can define the priority value. Let me refresh the page. Now we can see that the priority for this image is also high, right? So in case there are many critical resources in that scenario, this attribute is also super helpful. So this is all about the default native tab. So now let's try to jump into NgOptimized directive. So I'm going to comment this code out quickly, and then we can compare that with what we just implemented. So I have the same images right here, which are similar to these images, which we just saw earlier. So the only difference here is this attribute here, right? So instead of source, we need to define ngsrc, and it has the name of the image as the value. So let me refresh the page, and we are exactly getting the same result here, meaning with this attribute, there is smart lazy loading capability, right? So Angular is able to figure out which images are relevant or which images are on the screen and has the priority at the moment. And as we scroll down, we can see other images being requested as well, right? So now let's make it more interesting here. So when we check here, the priority for both of these images are low. So I mentioned this property called face priority. This directive also can have a capability to add the priority. And it's pretty simple. We just need to add priority, and it doesn't require any other values. So just do priority. That's it. Now let's refresh the page. And as you can see that the priority of both of these eagerly loaded images are high. So far, I talked about 2 benefits of NgOptimized Image Directive, which were intelligent lazy loading, and the other was about prioritization of critical images, meaning we can set the priority of critical images or eagerly loaded images. The next thing I want to talk about is built-in errors and warnings that comes with this directive as well. So as you can see here on all the images, I have explicitly define the width and height of each image. If I remove any of the attribute, either width or height, we'll be getting some errors on the console. So if you look closely here, it's saying that ng-source has detected that required attributes are missing, which in our case is the height. The reason for throwing this issue is to prevent us from this issue of layout shifts or reflow. Let me explain that quickly. Imagine we have some text just below the first image right here, and we have not defined the height like so. Now, browser will not be able to find the actual height of the image until it gets rendered on the viewport. Let's imagine the text gets rendered first, meaning the text will be rendered somewhere here. And later when the image gets rendered, it will be pushing that content just below it. Meaning browser will also need to recalculate all those coordinates, right? So that it can render and paint all those text and nearby elements correctly. And this is not good from the user experience perspective as well. So this directive is trying to enforce these rules so that we'll never run into this kind of scenario. The next thing I want to show you is about the aspect ratio. So if you look here, we have width of 1000 and the height is 1100, right? So that's the actual width and height of the image. So now if I try to change this width and height to different aspect ratio, so let's say I want to make it 500. So this aspect ratio is way different than this aspect ratio, right? And the risk of defining different aspect ratio is that we'll get bad quality images, right? Which might have been stressed and so on. So if I refresh the page, we'll be getting some more errors here as well. If you look here, right, the image size is this and this, and the aspect ratio is this, but the width and height I just supplied is not correct, right? So it's saying to optimize this aspect ratio right here so that we can provide good user experience. The next thing I want to bring up now is the another rule that this directive enforces us to use. That rule is we need to have this tag called preconnect. Up until now, we have been getting this one more warning. If you look here, it's saying ng-optimizedImage element has detected there is no preconnect tag, right? So let me add that tag quickly here on our index.html page. So this is what this tag looks like. We just need to define preconnect on the rel attribute and the name of the server we want to preconnect to. And the reason for adding this tag is to establish the early connection with this server, which is hosting all of our images. It's because during the process of server connection, your user agent has to go through several network trips, which involves DNS lookups and so on. So if we can do this thing early in the process, when the time comes to download the actual image, your user agent doesn't have to go through all these steps again, right? So the goal here is to load the image as soon as possible to speed up the loading of your application. Let me refresh this page one more time. So we didn't see any pre-connected related warning here. Lastly, I'm going to cover a few other additional attributes that are supported by this directive. I'm not going to write all of those attributes here, but it's good to know that it also supports all these attributes. For example, it supports this attribute called ng-src-set, sizes, and so on. So basically, these attributes are used to define different sizes of image to support responsive design. And also, this directive provides a function called loader. So the idea of loader is that we can set up our base URL on this function. And when we actually use the directive here, we just need to provide the name of the image without the base URL, because this base URL and other related configuration will be part of the loader. That's pretty much it for this video. I hope this video helps. If you have any questions or comment, please write me down below. And lastly, please share and subscribe to my channel. This will help a lot to grow my channel. Until then, see you on the next video. Bye bye.